मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। हाय शिल्पा।
मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। मॉर्निंग मैम।
हाय हाय हाय। तो शिल्पा, आई एम पंक्चुअल। आई सेड 10:55 एंड आई एम देयर।
वो भी चल।
हाँ
सावित्री जी, आर यू देयर? आई एम ऑन माय फोन सो आई डोंट हैव अ ग्रिड व्यू।
Savitri ma'am is about to join, ma'am.
Okay, great, great, great. And how many participants do we have so far?
Around 140.
Okay, good. So, Shilpa, you'll be muting everybody when it starts, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Good morning, Swati.
Good morning. Good morning, Professor Singh. So good to have you back with us again. Thank you so much, as always, for making time for us.
We've been fiddling with your Zoom last 2 days. You know that, no?
Yes, yes, I'm aware. Good for us. You're the best person to fiddle around with this, with it, and tell us more features that we can use. We are quite new to it.
Yeah, yeah. Even I'm new to it. But
yeah, yeah. But anyway, it's a mutual, learning and teaching thing that's happening when it comes to these apps right now. We're all kind of picking it up.
Yeah, yeah.
So what's happened is that a lot of people have been asking me for a recording of this, because simultaneously there's so many webinars happening even within DU. So lots of people have said, please provide us with the recording and so on. So of course we are recording the whole webinar.
Some people are showing it simultaneously on Facebook.
Yes, and there is a live streaming.
Simultaneously on Facebook, it gets recorded automatically.
Correct, correct.
And it's available on Facebook at all time.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Maybe we can do it, next time, as we haven't worked on it.
You can do it on your JDM page.
Yes, yes.
So that it gets recorded there forever.
Yes, correct, correct.
Yes, I mean, this you can put it up on YouTube if you
want. That's yes, great. I think we can do that. We can always convert all these recordings into YouTubes, and then I think we are planning to do that, right, Shilpa?
Yes, yes, we are recording. It's just that, since we are streamlining things right now, so it's taking a little time, but we are in that process. So recording is available. We'll be uploading all of them on our college YouTube or Facebook page.
Yeah, yeah.
So you could create a JDM channel on YouTube and put all your videos there at the same
time. That's a good suggestion. Yes, yes. So Shilpa, we could start on time, maybe in 5 minutes, and then you can keep admitting people, as they wish to enter.
Yes,
since a lot of people have joined on time, so we should be punctual and start it. Savitriji, I must tell you that we got a lot of positive feedback for the plagiarism, the first webinar.
Was an important topic you took.
Yes, yes, and it went off so well, and it was people have really, really appreciated it, and I got a.
What happened?
Dr. Pal, we can't hear you.
Some network problem with the ma'am, I guess.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes, you are audible. Of course you're audible. Those who cannot hear, they seem there must be some kind of a problem on their side, you know, because you're very, very clear. Shilpa, I think from time to time you must keep saying something. People are beginning to believe that there is no sound only. That's because we haven't started speaking. Shilpa, unmute yourself.
We'll just take 2 minutes more. We'll start the session, right? Just 2 minutes
right.
more.
Sure. My request to all participants is that when it starts, if you could, you will be unmuted, but if you could also close your screens, your video screen, the quality will improve, the quality of the Zoom webinar will improve. I can see many familiar faces from college and it's so good to see them. Jayanti, hello. I can see you, Jayanti. I can't see the faces, but I know that there's Manisha Agnihotri and who else? Let me see.
Good morning, Dr. Pal. Good morning.
Good morning. Meghna, Tara Negi. How nice. Good to see familiar.
Good morning, ma'am. I'm also there.
Who's that?
Good morning, ma'am.
Who's that? I don't have a grid view, so I'm on my phone, you know.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sudha Upadhyay here.
Hi, Sudha. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Hi. You know, I sometimes feel we meet each other more now over this medium. there's Indu. There's Ekta.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Poonam ji.
Good morning, Dr. Pal. Gurinder here.
Hi, Guri. Good to see you. Good to see you.
Hi. Good morning, Dr. Pal.
Good morning. Anshu. Hi, Anshu ji. Good morning.
How are you?
Hoping good webinar. We're all very, very webinar. Hi, Ruby.
Good morning, Shilpa.
Yeah,
good morning.
Hi.
Thank you.
Hi.
Good morning,
Dr. Ritu here.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Ritu.
Hi, Ritu.
Good morning, ma'am. Good
morning, ma'am.
Hi, Dr. Pal. Bye.
Good morning, Dr. Pal. I am Madhu Gupta from Commerce.
Yes, Madhuji. You don't have to tell me.
Thank you.
Good morning.
All right. I think we make a quick start here. Let me read out some instructions for the participants. I hope I'm audible. Yes. Participants are requested to keep their microphone off. Please keep yourself mute. You can keep your video on, plus please remember your video is visible to others. If at any point of the session you get disconnected, you can always rejoin the session by using the same meeting link. And questions will be taken at the end of the session, so please type your questions in the chat box. And there are some very important instructions for attendance purposes and e-certificate. Please write your name as well as institution in the chat box, And we are going to write the link for Google attendance form in the chat box. Please do fill it up. Please do fill it up, because these details will be used for your e-certificates. And please be careful the way you type your name and institution, the way, exactly the same way they are supposed to appear on your certificate. So type your name and institution in the Google attendance form very carefully. And then the most important question, how are you going to get your e-certificates? So after you submit your attendance form, we are going to send you a confirmation mail. And that mail is going to contain the link from where you can download your e-certificates after a week. So give us 7 days time. Within that, we are going to surely upload your e-certificates. So I guess we are all in a digital age, and we are surrounded by web content. Most of us will be users. Many of us may be creators, but we all need to understand, as users or creators, the licensing aspects of this web content material. So I, on behalf of IQAC, Janki Devi Memorial College, University of Delhi, welcome all of you to today's webinar on web content licensing. I welcome Dr. Swati Pal, Principal JDMC, and our esteemed resource person for the day, Professor Savitri Singh. A very quick introduction of our dear principal, Dr. Swati Pal, Charles Wallace Scholar, John Megrith Theatre Studies Scholar. She was the first Asian to receive the John Megrith Award. Dr. Pal has authored several books and newspaper articles. She is Vice President of IAC LALS and an Executive Body Member of IASA. She has presented a number of papers at various conferences, received several awards. Dr. Pal also writes poetry. Dr. Pal, we are so glad to have you as a leader, and thank you for supporting us in all our meaningful ventures. So I request you now to say a few words.
I really don't want to stand between the speaker and the participants, but as per protocol, I would like to, of course, warmly welcome Professor Singh for a second time. It's been very, very gracious of you, Professor Singh, to give us this time. And you are the best person to speak to all of us about licensing and how to obtain them and what is the importance.
Dr. Pal, you are not audible. I think there is some connectivity issue.
And is it a problem? It's stopping for some strange reason. Right. Shall I continue now?
Yes, we can hear you now.
Right. So I was saying that, you know, you are the best person to tell us about licensing at a time when all of us, when a lot of us want.
Dr. Pal, we can't hear you. I think there is some audio issue.
I think there is some kind of an issue happening. I think we should just start right away with Professor Singh. Professor Singh, welcome.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So let me take you to a quick tour of profile of our esteemed speaker for the day, Professor Savitri Singh. She served as principal AMDC University of Delhi. Ma'am is a trained botanist. Over the years, her interest broadened to science education and then to open education. She strongly believes that education needs to extend beyond the classroom and that research has to start early. Professor Singh has proudly led her college to several awards and recognitions, including Opal Award, Award for Good Practices, NAC score of 3.31, setting up a business incubator, among others. Ma'am has traveled widely for academic purposes. She has served as important positions in various committees and commissions. fellow Center for Science Education and Communication, member National Knowledge Commission, member National Focus Group on Teaching of Science, expert on open education resources for UNESCO and Commonwealth of Learning, member CEMCA India Core Team on Quality Assurance and Multimedia Learning Materials, member Syllabus Committee, author and for NCERT textbooks for biology and EBS. Professor Singh has served as advisor, research on open educational resources in the Global South, Cape Town, South Africa, and IDRC Canada funded project. Affiliate of Creative Commons in India. Presently, Professor Singh is current country lead and global network member of Creative Commons. We welcome you, ma'am. Thank you so much for accepting our invite and joining us today.
Thank you very much, Shilpa and Dr. Pal, for this opportunity. As a country lead of Creative Commons, it's also my responsibility to inform more and more people about country lead and about the need to be careful about licenses when we put materials on the web. And I'll start my presentation. So basically we are, let me share screen first. Oh, host has disabled attendee sharing screen. So you have to...
Yes, ma'am. Just a minute. Sonal, please enable that option.
I've done that, ma'am.
Okay. It's allowing me to share. So all of you can see?
Yes, ma'am. It's visible.
Yes, ma'am.
You need to go on to slideshow mode, Savitriji.
Okay, I'll do that. Okay. Is that okay now?
Yes, ma'am.
Perfect.
So today, in this 1 hour, we are trying to understand what is licensing of web content and how to choose the correct license for your content, and to make sure that when you use content from the web, you are actually following the norms of the license on which the content is. So before we really start, I'm going to ask Shilpa to post a few polls. Now, I want all of you to answer those polls immediately. I mean, the moment the question comes up, choose one or two of the alternates and give the answers. So the first question, Shilpa. Have you ever yourself uploaded any web content? Please, all of you, punch either yes or no. Is this available to everybody?
Yes, it is. I just answered.
Okay. Has everybody answered?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I just stop the recording.
So, Shilpa, I'm not able to see that screen, and not able to see the result of the poll. So, I think
most people have written yes, that they have submitted something to the.
They've done it themselves.
Yes, that's what they've written. They've written yes, so I'm presuming that they have.
Okay. I mean, if you haven't submitted it yourself, do you contribute to any online content? Say you submitted to the college or to your university or to some common site. Second question, Shilpa?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not able to get the answer, the results.
Okay. And just a minute. I'll try and give you focused.
So what is the majority here?
Yes.
I think here too it is yes. Okay. And I just want to share, like, a lot of us who are from Delhi University, some of us have written for, you know, sites like for the ILLL and so on.
Yeah, yeah. So, virtual learning environment, the VLE. Yeah. The next question, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Under which license do you upload your web content in case you do it yourself? Does it say it's a copyright? Is there no license mentioned? Or do you choose a Creative Commons license?
Majority is saying no license mentioned.
No license mentioned. Yeah. Okay. So shall we go to the next question?
Yeah, it's.
I mean, so through this process, I am expecting participants to understand the kind of questions they must ask themselves while uploading content. And, you know, try and find answers for those questions. These are the questions you must ask yourself. I mean, if no license is mentioned, why is no license mentioned? Is it not copyright? Can you not put it under a Creative Commons license? So those are the questions. Next question, please, Shilpa.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm just looking the next question. Yeah.
We are doing this polling for the first time, so bear with us, all of you participants. Who has the license on material created by you? So it's created by you and it's uploaded on the site. So who has the license? The institution for which you created? You have the copyright? Does the funding authority that gave you money to make e-content, do they have the license? Or is it again that you do not know who has the license? Now, where is the maximum answers? What percentage?
And almost 50% people are saying they don't know. And roughly around 35-36% are saying the institution for which I created the material has the license.
Okay. See, if you are saying that the institution has the license, does your institution have a policy, a licensing policy, that says that any material created by any teacher in my college will belong to the college or to the university? I mean, there should be some clear-cut policies. I mean, supposing I am a botanist and I create materials in botany. Is it that my college will have right on my botany materials? Or will it have also a right on materials I write a poetry, for example. Will it have a right on that also? So those are the kind of questions that institutions must ask and put in place a policy which defines all these things very clearly. Okay, next, is there any other question, Shilpa?
Yes, ma'am, Creative Commons.
Please put that, yeah. Okay, before I come to Creative Commons,
yeah.
I also conducted this questionnaire among some participants. And I asked them, do you need to seek permissions for use of any copyright material in your content? Did you seek permission? I mean, most of you have said you have written materials for the web. Did you seek any permission to put materials on the web when you've taken it from somewhere. And as you can see from the survey I did, 44% didn't know whether the institution had sought permission. Some people said 14%, 15% said the permission was taken by the organization. Some people said that proper permissions were taken. 13% said, I did not because I was creating educational content, so it's okay. So there are these very, very different views on taking permissions when you're creating content for the web. And we should know these various situations, and we should know where we should be. Should be in the red or yellow or green or blue or wherever. Now, who has the copyright? This is the one that I asked just now. And again, like you said, in the institution has, my survey also showed that 59% of the teachers felt the institution had the copyright. But again, when you question them further, they are not very sure where it is written that the institution has the copyright. Okay. Now, can I, Shilpa, ask you to bring in the next question?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you heard of Creative Commons? I mean, when I say heard, somebody may have heard of it just like that, but do you understand it also? What is Creative Commons? Have you heard of it in a way that you know what it is? So how many say yes and how many say no?
Roughly 70% say they don't know. They haven't heard of it.
Okay.
Roughly 70%, 68% to 70%.
Okay. So that's a huge number. And as people who put content on the web, we should be in a better position. So maybe at the end of the day today, at the end of the hour, you people will be better placed. Next question. Have you heard of open educational resources? I mean, this is actually the same question in a different form. But some people might find the term open educational resources somewhat more familiar. So how many say yes and how many say no?
Yes, ma'am. Now, roughly 75% say yes. 75% say yes, and 25% are saying no.
No, okay. Now, can you remove the poll?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I'm going to ask you another question. You have put content on the web, and some of you know what license they are in, some of you don't know what they are in. But do you know what other people can do with your content? What are the permissions that are available for the e-content created by you? One, can they be translated and put on other websites after due attribution? I mean, they don't take your permission, but they say, okay, we have used Dr. Pal's material and they put it on their website. Can it be modified and put on other websites? Modified, it could be translated. It could be they write a further explanation on some paragraph. It's a poetry that Dr. Pal has put online and they decide to take the poetry and give explanations and then put it online. Are they allowed to do that? Can they copy it and distribute it and share it with other people? Are they allowed to combine other materials and put it on web? There's a lovely poetry. Can they put some paintings or drawings that go with it? And they can they put it on their website with these beautiful paintings and these this lovely poem by Dr. Pal? Can, are they allowed to do that? Or is it that permission has to be taken from you before they do any of the above? So you have to be worried about what happens to your content once it goes on board. Or is it that you really don't know? You only know that principal ma'am said, please write some content and put it on web. You don't know the license. You don't know what others can do with it. You don't know your legal position with regard to your content. Is it that? Now what happens? Why is it not going forward? Just bear with me, my presentation is not going forward. Okay, now I want you to write in the chat box the license that's given on any wiki page.
Have a poll question on this.
Okay. Do you know the license that's given to any Wikipedia page? Where can I see the chat box, Shilpa? Okay. Yeah.
Ma'am, the results are almost 84% say that they don't know. 84%.
Okay. So why don't you all open up a wiki page and Wikipedia page, any Wikipedia page, and try and look for the license? It's at the base of the page. Open up any Wikipedia page and look at the bottom. You will find a license on the page. Can any of you just look it up and tell me what it is? You can open your page on your cell, on your computer, wherever, any Wikipedia page. That's not difficult to do, just try that. Yeah, so Ruchi Kalita has said CC by SA 3.0. Okay. CC by SA. Now, do any of you know what CC by SA stands for? Yes or no? Just yes or no. No. Okay. So today, basically, we are trying to understand that. Okay. Okay, so now let's come to understanding things a little bit. When you say digital content, you mean things like textual content, audio, video, it could be images, it could be software, it could be advertisements, it could be news, it could be maps. It could be almost anything, films, almost anything that you see online. And all these materials obviously have to carry some licenses, because content always belongs to somebody. There is no content that doesn't belong to anybody. Just a minute. Okay, so first thing, any material on the web is de facto copyright. Okay, so you cannot take materials off the web and use it. You can look at it, you can study it, you can, okay, it's a beautiful picture, you can say it's lovely, But you can't take it down, download it and use it for whatever you do, like we all do. We do that all the time, but we are not. Because all content is basically copyright on the web, unless it is specified otherwise. And how do you specify it? I mean, you can say it's open license and you can make statements, but it's always easier to use some short form which indicates that it's under an open license. And that short form comes from Creative Commons. So digital content access is very easy. It's unless it's password protected, which so many journals are, or they require registration. Some of them, payment may be required. But in all cases, copying is very easy. And that is what we have to be careful about, that we do not copy other people's material, nor that other people copy our materials. So there are about 1 billion or more, now of course it might be about 1.3 billion openly licensed works that is there on the websites that you can use with much more ease than using copyright materials. And some of the examples of openly licensed material are Wikipedia, Flickr, PLOS, Open Access, Vimeo, Khan, Boundless, all these. And in YouTube, if you upload content, you have to specify what license you want to put it in. If you upload photographs on Flickr, you are forced to mention the license. And that is very important, that people believe in licenses and that any content on web should be licensed. Open Access India is a portal that promotes open access of journals and articles. Open Access, this one is the world one. So now we come to Creative Commons. It's a non-profit organization which offers a set of free and voluntary copyright licenses. So it's not as if Creative Commons does not believe in copyright. It believes in copyright, but it believes that you should place it, your content, under some conditions. And it provides a simple, standardized way to give public permission to share, use your creative works on conditions of your choice. See, when you say something is copyright, you say the thing is closed and you cannot use it. Okay? Unless you take my permission. Copyright material you can use with permission. But when you say it's Creative Commons, you again say the material is mine, but you can use it under these conditions. And what are the various conditions that we talk about? Most important is attribution. You can't use a Creative Commons material unless you attribute, unless you say you've taken it from X or from that book or from that Wikipedia page. The other attribution you can give your material is share alike. That means you can use my material, but you have to place it under the same Creative Commons license. You cannot take a Creative Commons licensed material and put it under copyright. Then you non-commercial. That means you say, please use my material and do whatever you want to do with it. But if you are making commercial use of it, I have the right on it and I will tell you what you can do. So non-commercial. And last is non-derivative. As long as I use your material as such, I can do it. I need to only say I have used this material, but I'm not allowed to make derivatives. What's a derivative? the earlier example we took Swati Pal's, Dr. Pal's poetry, and somebody decided to add images to it. That is a derivative. And that derivative is not allowed. So under these four conditions of attribution, share alike, non-commercial and non-derivative, you can mix and match. So the first one is attribution. You have to credit the original source if you would like to use the image or the content in any way. This, I mean, I'm talking as if you are using it, but the same rules apply when you put your materials. When you put your materials under attribution, other people will have to quote your name, your site, when they modify it, build upon it, distribute it, or publish it. And how do you attribute? You give the title of the work, you give the name of the author, you give the kind of license, and since we are talking about web content, you have to give the links. See, web content is not a book. It's usually a link. And obviously, when you give links, you have to also give the date. Because what may be on a web page today may differ, may be different on another day. So on the day you took the link, you have to give the date. Next is share alike. So if you put your material as attribution, share alike means people can use your material with attribution and they have to use the same license when they use the material. Non-commercial, you're allowed to remix, adapt, modify, do everything, anything with your material, or you can use any material that has a non-commercial license to do remix, adapt, modify, as long as you are not making money out of it. Non-derivative, this I told you earlier. So using these four attributes, you can make six different Creative Commons licenses by mixing and matching. CC BY, you're taking attribution only. So people are allowed to do anything with it, even commercially, make derivatives, but they have to attribute. Attribution share alike. This is the one that we all promote, the Creative Commons group promotes. And this is the one that all your Wikipedia and all any other wiki has. This is the same license on which many of the YouTube materials are there, or Flickr or any of these things. Here, you can use the material, you can do anything with it, but that material that you create or anybody creates using your material, you have to use the same share alike, same license. They cannot change the license. It cannot become more stringent. CC BY, no derivatives. That means it's a Creative Commons license. It has got attribution and no derivatives. CC BY NC. How many of you are familiar with this if you are from Delhi University? I'm asking this question because most of the content that is uploaded, that was uploaded by IELTS, had this license. It was Creative Commons. It needed attribution and people were allowed to use it as long as they were using it non-commercially. So you could take that material, put it on your website, modify it, etc. But you shouldn't be making money out of it. And this is the license that VLE, the Virtual Learning Environment of Delhi University, the IELTS materials had. At the moment I see they have, if nothing is there, no license is there on the content. Attribution, non-commercial, share alike, and this is a very restrictive license because non-commercial, no derivatives. So it's almost like copyright. Except in case of copyright, you have to take permission to use it. Here you can use it by just attribution. But non-commercial, non-derivative. So you can't change it in any way. So when you look at these licenses, the most open is CC0. I haven't mentioned it. I'm going to do it just now. And just CC BY. And the others, as you go down, they become narrower and narrower. And at the base, you have attribution, non-commercial, non-derivative, which is almost like copyright. If there is so much openly licensed, I told you there is one online that's openly licensed. And many of you must be parents at the moment and looking after young children. And you must have seen the Khan Academy work. Now, Khan Academy work is also Creative Commons license. So when you put materials, most of us do not put any licenses on our content. And most of us do not bother about licenses when we copy off the web, believing that anything on the web is free. But that's not true. You know that. Obviously, when there is so much of openly available content on the web, plagiarism is on the rise, and we have to depend on anti-plagiarism software. Another problem is we do not know how to get credit to web content. When you write a paper and you quote from a book or from a journal, you know how to give the quotation. We do not know how to give credit to web content. All it needs is giving the URL and the date. And if you know the name of the author. And then we do not know that websites and all content is supposed to be licensed. We do not even know this fact. Now I must take you to a meeting that was held at the world level by UNESCO, 2012, as well as 2017, when governments from all over the world, including ours, has signed an agreement saying that all publicly funded educational materials will have open licenses. Okay, why is it jumping? Wait, just a minute. I have to go back now. I don't know. I'm not able to change the slide when I'm in a... I'm not able to change the slide when I'm in a slide view.
I'm in the slideshow. You can just click on any side, any corner of the screen. Left or right corner.
Moving properly. That's what happened. Okay. So when you publish under Creative Commons, you retain all rights that you have in terms of the copyright law, and you grant some permissions for use of the material. And what is most important is that CC licenses are perpetual. Once you put content up online as a CC, it cannot be revoked. You cannot later go and make it a copyright. Whereas a copyrighted material, the author can say, okay, I withdraw my copyright, anybody can use it. So be careful that CC licenses are perpetual. Now, this is one public domain mark that you can use. This is given to content where the material that's there comes into public domain after 60 years death of the author. So many of our big books, for example, all Rabindranath Tagore's work came into public domain 60 years after his death. So this is something that allows content to come into public domain. I can put, or anybody can put their own material under CC0 or no rights reserved. This you can do only with your own material. And for example, the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York, they put all the materials they had under a CC0. That means you can copy it, you can print it, you can modify it, you can use it in your book, you can use it on the online, do anything with it. And you don't even have to take permission. All you need, you don't need to do anything because even attribution is not there. Buy is also not there. So when you look at these licenses, there are three layers. Of course, this license is a legal license. So there is a legal code. Then there is what you write or draw, the buy, CC, SA, ND. This is the human readable line. And when you put a license, there is a machine readable version. That means the moment you put these licenses on the content, the machine, the computer comes to know that this is an open educational resource or it is a CC licensed work. So these three layers are important. And we are, of course, bothered only about the human readable layer. So some of us also make digital collections, and the most famous digital collection in India is the National Digital Library, which I hope all of you are consulting. It is a collection of a lot of thousands and thousands and thousands, or rather millions of digital work from India and abroad. And you can easily access it through the digital library, National Digital Library. But the content, all the content out there is accessible, but many of it may be copyrighted or may have other licenses, and you have to check for the license before you use the material. So please check the copyright status of materials from their original source in case even you are making a digital collection. See, one of you might decide, okay, I teach commerce. Let me make a digital collection of materials for my students. You can do that, but remember the state, copyright status or the license status. You cannot release copyrighted material under any free license. So you cannot pick up a copyrighted material and say, it's free for use, I do whatever you like. And even CC licenses are graded. Oh God, I've jumped. And you have to be careful. All collections should be licensed, and collections with no license are invariably breaching copyrights. If there is any content on web which doesn't have a license, be very careful. It may be breaching copyright. Now I'm going to take you this is a statement, again, it jumps. Sharing is fundamental to how we promote discovery, innovation, and collaboration in the digital age. And this has proved even more true in the present day, because due to COVID, a lot of institutions have opened up their content and made it available, be it films, be it books, be it libraries, be it, I don't know what, everybody has put open licenses in the last 2 months and made it all available. And as teachers, for us, sharing is fundamental because that is what we do every day. And now this is, I'm here mentioning about the National Mission on Education using ICT, which is an initiative of the MHRD, and they have put a lot of material online. MOOCs in the form of Swayam, digital courses, Paathshala, Shobh Chandu, Yatra, spoken tutorials, virtual labs, everything. But when you start looking at licenses, you will find in some of them, at least I find problems. For example, Swayam. It says it may be reproduced free of charge after taking permission by sending mail. However, the mail has to be reproduced, the material has to be reproduced accurately. So instead of making all these statements, if they had just put a CC by non-derivative license, this would have been, I mean, what they are saying in sentences here would have been much more simpler. Now, Swayam Prabha videos that are there, here the copyright is with Swayam Prabha. So if you have made a video for them, remember you are also handing over copyright to them. Plagiarism detection software, this is provided by the government called Shodh Shuddhi, and you can use this freely. All you need is to go to the website and upload the content that you want to check for plagiarism, and it gives you the results within minutes. Now, those of you who teach computers, you might have used this site. I don't know whether you have, but if you haven't, Spoken Tutorials by IIT Bombay is under a CC by SA license. That means you are free to use it. It's an open educational resource. And it gives you spoken tutorial for various free, open and free softwares. It's a very beautiful site, and we used to use it regularly for our teaching our students how to do Linux or any of the open and free software. It's a wonderful site with a CC by SA license. Many of you may have gone to this site, FOSSI, free and open source software. And again, this is under a CC by SA license. One of the best licenses we can have for sharing. Okay. And the DU website suggests online platforms for teaching. And here the DU suggests Google Classroom and the Google Hangout that we should use for our teaching learning. They of course say you can use WebEx, Zoom, Loom, Skype, etc. And all this is incorporated, and you can use all these things also through the DU website. This is the VLE page, vle.du.acin, where it says that the content is an open educational resource. But as of now, it says it's under a Creative Commons license, but it also says copyright IELL, it says Creative Commons, but when I talked to Sanjeev Singh, he said it would be, oh God, now what is this? They would be putting a Creative Commons share alike, non-derivative, non-commercial license. Thank you very much. And I will now stop share. Okay, and now I'm ready to go for questions, if any. Shilpa, please take over.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. That was really required. There are so many technical terms. The new terminology, it may be new to many of us. So we need to really get acquainted. There are many questions, ma'am.
So can I take them one by one?
Yes, ma'am. And you talked about three layers. I think there was one participant asking about, requesting you to explain those three layers again.
Okay.
There was one slide.
Three layers when you write, supposing I put some content on the web. For example, one of the things, the content I do put on web all the time is I put images. I am a bird photographer and I put photographs of birds online. So when I put it online, I usually put a license on it which says CC by SA. So when I say CC by SA, this is the layer that is human readable. That means you can see it, you can see CC by SA and you know that it is all you need to do if you want to use that material is you give me attribution. And you have to share the material with the same license. You can modify it, you can do whatever. But the legal layer means supposing somebody takes me to court or you to court, it also has a legal implication. And that is the legal layer. So there is a lot of legal language written for all these. What does CC actually mean? What does BY actually mean? What does share alike mean? There's a lot of legal jargon that is written and which can be understood by the lawmakers. So when you take things to court, which sometimes people do, then the legal layer comes into force that since I've written CC by SA, they understand what it means legally. The third layer is the machine readable line. I forgot to mention this. If any of you want to license your content, the best way to do it is by going to the creativecommons.org website and choosing your license. So when you choose your license through the creativecommons.org website, then automatically there is some metadata linked with it, which machines can read, which you and me will not be able to see. But machines can read and they can read it as being an open education resource or as being a Creative Commons license. Supposing I write CC by SA on my image, the machine can't read it. The machine can't read language as we do. But if you do it through the Creative Commons website, then the third layer of the machine readable layer comes into play. So all these three layers are important. Okay. So, and it can be done through the Creative Commons license. Okay. Next.
Can I just ask a quick question? Savitriji, since you kept giving my example of poetry, now you've got me worried. Because one of the things that I've been doing is that I write a lot on social media, like say Facebook. Yeah. I definitely do not wish that to be used. So what does that mean? That every time I put up something on Facebook, I need to
At least mention that it is copyright.
Okay.
At least mention that. Or, these kind of social media, they do not allow you the option of giving a license.
Right.
When you put things up on YouTube, when you put things up on Flickr, when you put things up on any of the other sites, you have to mention the license you want to put it in. So it makes you safe. But the social media doesn't. So all you can do is you can write that this material is copyright and may not be reproduced without permission.
Okay.
So that is important. At least do that. Otherwise, only publish in spaces where you can put your license.
Right.
And I would recommend anyway putting it as an CC by SA that you come to know any, I mean, at least people attribute you when they use your materials.
Right. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other question?
Yes, ma'am. And there's one question from a participant that suppose if we contribute to blogs, etc. So does that also come under licensing purview?
Blogs also you should put licenses. I mean, don't put any content. I mean, your license may be CC0. You might say, okay, use it freely. Your license, CC by, NC by, ND, or you might even say copyright. But do put licenses. Don't put any content out there without a license. You might, I mean, I feel very open about it. I put all my images, I put it under a CC by SA. That means you are free to use it, you are free to modify it, you are free to even make commercial use of it. But you have to attribute it. You have to say this image is taken from her. So it's up to your personal belief that makes you choose the license. But do put a license. That's my statement about it.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, there's a question. What is the difference between ISO and copyright?
ISO? Exactly. That is a standard. An ISO mark is when you meet a particular standard, you get a mark. Copyright is only given to, ISO mark is given to things that can be made at different levels. And when you reach a particular standard, you reach an ISO standard. Copyright is only saying you made the material and it belongs to you. I mean, there is no question. I mean, I can write a bad, I mean, if Swati will write a beautiful poetry, I can write a bad poetry, but Swati will have license on her poetry. I will have license on my bad poetry. So there is no standard available with a copyright. Copyright is just saying who has created the material.
I think copyright is just about ownership.
Yes,
when you say you that this belongs to somebody, whereas the ISO, as very rightly pointed out by Savitriji, is a certain standard that you attain for which you are given a marking. Yeah.
Ma'am, there's a question because these days, because of online things.
Can't hear.
Or at various other places. So should we put a license for that also?
I can't repeat the question.
Yeah. Ma'am, these days we are putting PPTs on our college websites or on various places. We are uploading our PPTs at many places. So should we write CC for those PPTs also?
See, one, while making PPTs, make sure you are not using copyrighted material, you are not plagiarizing. Most of us use a lot of content off the web and it is plagiarism. It's best that on each page, you give the source of your material. Number one. Number two, yes, do put a license on the content. Either copyright or one of the Creative Commons licenses. Please do that all the time. Never put it up there without a license. There are these sites which have so many PowerPoint presentations, the SlideShare, I don't remember, I'm forgetting the name of the site. And they ask you again, if you put up a presentation there, they ask you to give a license. It's important. Just remember, just like when you publish anything hard, you publish a book, you do write the licenses. I mean, government material might say you are free to copy, etc., etc. Your private material, you might say it's my copyright. And the web is also another way of publication. And any publication should carry a license. It's as simple as that. Don't think of it as different. It's something you published or your college website should be only accessible to your students in case it's a private space. which is not visible to the public, then maybe you can be careless about not putting licenses. But in case it's a public space, I mean, the question you have to ask is, can I, for example, come to your college website and look at a commerce teacher's presentation? In case I can, then it should carry a website. In case only your students or only members of your community can see it, then maybe you can do away with the license. It depends on how you've hosted it.
But I think you will perhaps it is advisable for some
I can't hear you.
Mute everybody except me and ma'am.
Please unmute three of us.
Yeah, right. So what I was saying is that I still feel that it would be advisable, because if you're saying that even on a website where, for example, only the teachers of this college can or the students can, we do not know thereafter if they are going to copy it and then, you know, share it.
So this is really important.
Yeah. So perhaps it is advisable in any case to always have, you know, if you're putting up something which is your own, to get it, you know, copyrighted, in the sense to assert your own ownership over it.
Yeah, even if you put a CC license, it's again good enough, because it's a, there's an attribution.
Right.
I mean, I am a promoter of copyleft. So I would still say put it under CC license rather than copyright. But yes, do put a license. That's what my main thrust today is, look at licenses on the web before you use the content, and put licenses on what you put up on the web.
Right.
Ma'am, there was one question. Suppose we put up some kind of license and it is violated. Then how do we deal with it?
See, there is a legal course. One course is simple. You write to them and you say that you've done this and please take it down. Some of them agree. And many of them say, we didn't even know this had a license. I mean, like now, Wikipedia page has a license at the bottom of every page. And 70% of the people did not know it had a license. So very often, this is done by people who do it by mistake. And if it is done by mistake, a letter to them, an email to them normally prevents them from doing it. But otherwise, in case it's a serious matter, you can take them to court. Like in any copyright breaching.
Shilpa, I think there was a question on the Supreme Court decision that I think Dr. Vibha Jain had put up. If you can locate that, could you ask that question? It's an important question.
That was about the photocopying?
Yes, yes.
If you all remember, there was a court case against one of the vendors near the university taking down, copying materials and making photocopies and binding it into a book and giving it to college students, selling it to college students. And in that case, it was decided by the court that it may be allowed, since he proved that he was not gaining anything commercially out of it. He actually went to court saying that if it is 50 paisa for photocopying a page, I'm not charging more than that. So, I mean, again, and I think the court somewhere took into consideration the fact that many of our students cannot afford to buy the very costly books. And it was justified because of that. But if you look at it from a very legal point of view, there was something wrong in that decision. It was mainly because of the consideration of the our students, their inability to buy these books, that the court agreed that it may be done at no cost, no profit, no loss basis. And he was
and there is one question. Is recreating content also a breach?
It depends on recreating content. If you are using somebody's content as a base, then it is a breach. You have to quote the original material. And in case it's copyrighted material, you have to take permission. In case it's a Creative Commons material, attribution material, you have to quote. So it all depends on what you mean by recreation.
I think whether you recreate, even if it is in a very minor way, even if it is, you know, in the last webinar that we had, which was on the general principles of plagiarism, we spoke about this at length, where we said that sometimes even a thought, you know, somebody may have just given an idea. If you're using that idea, even that actually without attributing it, you can use somebody's idea, but you need to attribute it. If you do not attribute it to the person concerned, then you are in effect plagiarizing even that thought. Sometimes we, you know, arrive at conclusions, you know, people arrive at certain conclusions after doing a survey. Now you quote the conclusions, you know, without attributing it. That is also plagiarism. So I think the question is that sometimes people say, oh, I only took two lines, I only took two words. Whether you take two words, whether you take two lines, whether you take an idea, anything which has been done by somebody else and you are using it in your own work without attribution is a breach.
Yeah. Only thing is, if it is a CC license, just by attribution, you can do it. If it's yes. a copyrighted material, you have to take permission. Written permission should be with you. So there's a slight difference between attribution and CC and copyright.
Correct, correct.
And one more question. You know, these days we are getting e-newspapers. So forwarding the e-newspapers, is that legal?
See, what has happened is, most of the newspapers have given out for free the e-newspaper. So there was one person, actually Dr. Gore, he was forwarding all these pages every day to a large group of people in the country. And one newspaper has challenged him, saying that you are plagiarizing. So he has questioned that, because each newspaper has made their e-paper free to access. How taking down the thing and forwarding is illegal. So he has questioned it, and I believe that since each newspaper has made their content freely available, it should not be a problem if I download it and forward it to you or to anybody else.
No, in fact, Savitri Ji, the Indian Express, there is a person from the Indian Express who sends me the e-paper every morning, and you know and I just forward that to all the teachers, because that's the way I'm.
What Dr. Gore was doing was, he was forwarding me all the newspapers, say yes. about 20 or 25 of them, and all many important magazines every day.
Yes.
And that was challenged. So he is now, we are thinking of whether to take it up further and make an issue of it, or just...
The link is available for all to use.
Freely available by the parent newspaper.
Right.
Then it doesn't really matter. It's just this difference. It's the commercial aspect, actually. If a paper makes a link available, that means I am forced to go to the Times of India site and click. I'm forced to go to Indian Express site and click. I'm forced to go to another site, Dainik Bhaskar site, and click. So it makes me go back to the paper every day. Whereas if I'm sent a PDF by Dr. Gore or you, that means I'm not interacting with the newspaper every day.
Directly.
directly. So maybe there is a commercial angle to it, an advertisement angle to it, in a way.
Would you strictly call that a breach? Would you call it a breach?
I would not. But I mean I can understand how the newspaper looks at it.
Yes.
So this is because they would also want to say we got 10,000 hits on our site. Whereas if you download and forward it to 10,000 people, they will get one hit and they won't know how many other people are reading that newspaper. They want to know how many people read their newspaper during COVID times. That goes missing.
Yes, very true. We didn't look at it like that. Yeah,
that's the reason why this aspect has come up.
And then a related question will be, suppose a link of the newspaper, not the complete newspaper, but just a link is sent. So that would be also something similar?
That should be happy because the paper will be happy. Mm-hmm. If the link is given to more people, many more people will click the link and they will get that many hits on their website. So now, actually, Dr. Gaur has sent me the links of all the papers. So if I want to see any particular paper, I have to go to the site, click it. But I have the links on one page. So right. I can choose. I want to read Times of India today. I want to read Indian Express today. Mm-hmm. Like that. Earlier, I was getting the front page of everything. And looking at the front page, I could decide which paper I want to read. Now I have to go to each site. So there's a slight difference.
Yes, our librarian also, Nivedita Ji, she also did a similar thing. She used to send us, probably she also got it from Dr. Gaur.
Yeah, and
she
would send us all.
So she would send it to all of us. And then this question was put up to her. So she's now sent us the links on one page. And we can, whichever one we want to have a look at, we can do
that. This is all, Dr. Gaur and me, we come from a world where we believe things should be shared. We are very clear on this. I mean, he and me, we've been doing this together for a very long time.
Right.
And we believe this. So for us, it's very easy to do these things. But when you look at it from the perspective of a business or from a commercial angle, then things become different.
One more question is there. If we write a mathematical theorem in a PPT, will it be called as plagiarism?
No, I mean, when you write a mathematical theorem, you are obviously giving the name of the person who made the theorem. And see, I told you somewhere, no? When we talked about plagiarism, there are some things that are known. Everybody knows. The theorem is Pythagoras' theorem mentioned kya. So you've done it, no? Pythagoras mein mention ho gaya. And you can use it anywhere. So if you're taking the theorems by name and all, it's okay.
I think again, Professor Singh, this goes back to last time's webinar where we talked about that there are certain known facts which can be like dates. I remember we mentioned the fact that, there are certain historical dates, for example, which are known, when did the World War I begin and so on, or the, Treaty of Versailles or something. So a certain commonly known historical facts would, if you mention it, it would not amount to plagiarism. Now, I don't know if well-known theorems also fall within that category.
Pythagoras theorem.
Right.
You're actually giving the name of the person, no? I mean, most theorems carry a name. So once you're mentioning the name, then it's fine. I mean, but it's up to the student to go back and find out where he gave it. I mean, maybe none of us know originally which paper was there which said gave the Pythagoras theorem or any other theorem, for example.
Right.
Is that all?
Yes, ma'am, a related question. Suppose the name of the theorem is not there, or there is something which is mentioned in many, many textbooks. So if we just take those portions and write there, they are available in Wikipedia also. So how do we cite those things?
It depends on how much of specificity you've gone into. Is it impinging on any one person's intellectual property? If it is something attributed to any one person and it has been repeated 20 times, doesn't mean that the original person hasn't done it. So it all depends on you'll have to take it case by case. I mean, quadratic equation, if you take. I mean, everybody knows a quadratic equation. I don't even know who made it. But we can use it because it's public knowledge. A square plus B, A plus B whole square is equal to, etc. Which our prime minister didn't know. That's a different thing.
Ma'am, there is a question. Suppose I have written a book 4 years ago. Is it possible to take the license for the same now?
Have you published it without a license? Where is it? Is it a hard book or a soft copy?
I think so. It is the hard book. Someone is asking the question. So I assume it is a hard book and someone has published it.
And they, hard can, book. Put yeah. a, they can put a license on it now.
They can, yes. Okay. They can. Thank you, ma'am.
But as you said, if it's web content, then we can't change it, right? We can't change the license.
No, we didn't initially have a license, no? So you can put a license.
Regarding the theorem, mathematical theorem, the participant is again asking one thing. They don't know the source that who has given the theorem, but if it is given in certain textbook, so do we reference that book?
It doesn't matter. If it is a well-known theorem, everybody knows it. I mean, at least all the mathematicians know it. I mean, an English teacher or a botany teacher may not know it, but a mathematician knows it, then it's fine.
If it's a and if it is not well known and it is mentioned in certain book, can we quote the book?
They have to quote the source.
Ma'am, one thing. Ma'am, suppose somebody uploads some content in SlideShare and let's say a few days later, the person gets a chance to write the e-content for, let's say, IELLL or some other institution. So can the same presentation be used which was uploaded on SlideShare?
It can be used, but it depends on the license. When you again upload it at wherever, then you must mention where it is originally uploaded. You can say it's uploaded on SlideShare, etc., link. So-and-so number, etc., then it's fine. SlideShare doesn't prevent you from reusing that content, but do give the source.
And ma'am, there are some participants who would like to know the process of the licensing.
It's very simple. Go to the creativecommons.org website and go to choose the license. And just go ahead and choose.
Okay, so we have to remember.
You have to upload your content there and you can do it. It's not difficult. It's very intuitive and it's very user friendly. If any of you are not able to do it, you can always come back to me with an email and maybe I'll write my email in this chat box. I gave it at the end of my slide. But I will give it here. It is singh.savitri with an H. Savitri has an H. And 111@gmail.com.
Professor Singh, a related question. Somebody had asked it right at the beginning. And I thought that was important. That each time that we upload something. Suppose I'm a writer who writes, periodically. So every time that I upload something, should I need to then put up, get a new license? Or one license works for all? How does it happen?
You need to, individual pieces have to have license. And whereas if you get it for a site, then the whole site will carry that license at the base. Just like your Wikipedia site has a license at the base. So it's obvious all the content there. Most of you must be knowing that we can all contribute to Wikipedia.
Yes.
I don't know. Have you created a page for JDM on Wikipedia? Question.
It's already, it's on it. It exists.
But then you can, when you try and fill it, add more information, you will see that the Wikipedia has inbuilt plagiarism check.
Okay.
So if you try and copy things from here and there, it doesn't allow you to. You have to write freshly for that. There's a big check on plagiarism in the Wikipedia, built-in check.
Okay.
And it's nice to have your pages there.
It's so ironic because I think the Wikipedia is the most plagiarized bicycle.
When you try and write something there, you will realize how much of a plagiarism check there is. It's amazing. Once I tried to write something and copy something from one wiki page to another, one from Wiki Educator to Wikipedia or something, and it said no. So I had to rewrite those sentences in a different way. And I said the same thing, but I had to rewrite the whole thing. It was about the college somewhere. And I had to write it in a different way totally. So there is a very big inbuilt plagiarism check. Or the content there is plagiarism free. What we do is we all plagiarize it and use it everywhere else. I mean, there's nothing to prevent us from copying things from Wikipedia and putting it on our website. That is how it seems to promote plagiarism. In itself, the content there has to be quoted. You have to give references. And no sentence can be plagiarized. I mean, no plagiarized sentence can be there in Wikipedia. It's all inbuilt. The way they do it. And I don't know if among here, is there any regular contributor of Wikipedia? They would know how tough it is to write even a paragraph for Wikipedia. I sometimes go in there and write a few lines of paragraphs and I find it tough. Because sometimes when you write, you have things in memory which you have read somewhere or, you know, it's there. And you tend to write it. And that will come out as plagiarized. And they will tell you where it came from also.
Ma'am, what about wiki images? Can one use wiki images?
Attribution. A wiki is a CC by SA. That means attribution, share alike.
Okay.
You can take the image, but you can't put that image in a copyrighted content.
All right.
You can take the image, put it in any content that you are sharing as CC by SA.
Okay. And how about YouTube links? Nowadays in online teaching, we are sharing YouTube links.
Also, please look at the various licenses. Most of them are copyright. So you are not supposed to copy it. We do all of, in India, we are famous for copying things. Right from the music and films, they are all copied from, you know, Western world, so many songs. But legally, if you look at it, what we are doing is wrong and we should not be copying this.
There's a very good question. This is from Sudha. She says, ma'am, bahut se sites aise bhi hote hain jahan se copy paste restricted hi hote hain. Simply hum wahan se links hi uthate hain. Kya wahan koi dikkat hai? Maine links ya tasveeron ke liye?
No. Links dena galat nahi hai. You are only directing them to a site which is giving the information they need. That is perfectly fine. The question is, are you downloading stuff and, you know,
from the link?
As long as you're giving links, it's absolutely fine.
Yeah, it's the same thing to like the newspaper. Yeah. When we're giving the link to the newspaper, then it is okay. But suppose I use the matter. Hello? Hello. So the thing is that if you give the links, I think then it's fine. But if you use the matter from the, like for example, Sudha, agar aapne khud bhi ek YouTube se kuch particular piece nikal ke usko use kiya, to wo plagiarism hai. Lekin agar aapne sirf wo YouTube link ko refer kiya ya forward kiya kisi ko, to wo breach nahi hai. That's my understanding.
Yeah, that's the right.
Ma'am, there is a question. Suppose we translate some material, maybe maths material in Kannada language or in any other language, can we take license for that?
It's like this. Again, what is the original content? If it is under copyright, you have to take permission to translate. And then he will tell you, the original author will tell you under what license you can publish. He or she might say, okay, you can say it's written by Dr. Jha and translated by so-and-so. Or he might say, it, you have to write, it is written by Trans Jha and Singh. It depends. If it is a Creative Commons share alike by license, you are free to translate. If it is a Creative Commons non-derivative license, ND, you cannot translate. If it is a Creative Commons by NC, non-commercial, you can translate as long as you use it non-commercially. You don't make money out of it. So you have to read these licenses very carefully, understand them, and then use it.
एक और क्वेश्चन आया है कि अगर हम अपने YouTube चैनल से ही स्टूडेंट्स को कुछ भेज रहे हैं तो उसके लिए भी क्या कोई लाइसेंस की जरूरत है?
YouTube चैनल इज पब्लिक. अपना मतलब अपना चैनल हो सकता है, JDM का चैनल हो सकता है या AND का चैनल हो सकता है, बट मटेरियल इज पब्लिक. सो वंस यू पुट पब्लिकली समथिंग, इट शुड कैरी अ लाइसेंस.
There's a question. Somebody's asked a question about an image. About
can I create a new image by using two or more images from the web? No. You have to give credit to the original image people. And if it is copyright, you have to not only give credit, you have to take permission. If it is CC BY, then if it is Creative Commons, you have to attribute. It's not easy. I think this whole thing of concepts is not easy, but it's important.
Okay, so I think we have answered most of the questions, I believe. So thank you so much, ma'am, Professor Singh, for this truly enlightening discussion. And I guess most of us know now. Ma'am, एक last question, can I please take?
Yeah, yeah.
For YouTube posting, do we need license for posting to YouTube?
Yes, वो तो it's built into YouTube. You can't post a license on YouTube without a license. They will ask you to choose a license. Okay. So you have to. YouTube आपको करने ही नहीं देगा post जब तक आप उस पर license नहीं डालेंगे.
Yeah, so I think we are formally coming to an end of this session. Thank you, Professor Singh, for that was a very truly enlightening discussion.
I enjoyed it.
And I think most of us now know that we hardly know anything about this whole issue. We are using things, we are creating things without probably the correct kind of rights and licenses. So I guess the next time, whenever we create or use any web content, the first thing that we must check is the license associated with it. And yeah, we need to make this our habit. It has to be our habit. Yeah.
And I welcome all of you to think of joining Creative Commons. You can become an institutional member of the Creative Commons Global Network. You can become an individual member of the network. And it gives you a lot of opportunity to, and you can even, some of you, you're maybe a librarian, can get trained on the Creative Commons licenses. They have an online course. So there are a lot of things happening in this world of licensing. And for to understand more, please, please go to the creativecommons.org website and you can learn about it all and maybe join us someday.
Yeah, because I think some participants are still asking the process of certification. So I think for everybody's benefit, creativecommons.org, that is the place to go. Am I right, ma'am?
Yes.
So creativecommons.org, that is the site that we need to go and you know, get the understand the process of certification and get the certificate. Ma'am, last words, Dr. Pal.
It's a very intuitive site and it's a very user-friendly site and people should be able to negotiate.
Yeah.
Thank you all very much. It was fun.
Dr. Pal, you'll have to unmute.
Yeah, please unmute.
Yes, I have muted. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you.
I said that it's very difficult to have last words on a webinar like this because I think everybody wants to just keep asking questions. So individuals are, I think Professor Singh is extremely accessible as a person. I should know, I have benefited immensely from her at a personal and a professional level because she is accessible to questions day and night. So please mail her your questions and, you know, she will answer you. I know that. Professor Singh, I really, in the beginning, I think there was something faulty with my side of the Zoom. So I wasn't able to do a good enough job of welcoming you. But I would like to, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for being so, you know, so clear. And this is where I've always said that only an expert and only somebody who really knows their work can have this kind of very, very clear information which you've conveyed so brilliantly to all of us. We have immensely profited from both last time's webinar and today's exclusive webinar with you. I know from the way I'm looking at the feedback that we will probably need yet another small session with you. So I hope you are not going to say no to us.
No, I'm never going to say no to you.
It was just absolutely enthralling. I mean, you know, who would have ever thought that a topic like this would be so mesmerizing? Possibly because we just don't know enough about it. And Shilpa, I completely endorse what you've said, that it's got to become a habit. This whole thing about, you know, attributing things and doing it correctly, including to our own selves. We do an injustice to our own selves sometimes. And I wasn't able to do this at the beginning, but I would like to thank you, Shilpa, as IQAC coordinator, and your entire technical team, Sonal, and everybody else who's been helping you out for very patiently handling things and for picking up so many new features. Again, for that, I thank you, Professor Singh, for helping us out. I wanted to say this, that as an institution, I'm really, really delighted that, you know, we've been able to do this webinar and it's been so beneficial to all of us. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed myself.
Okay, thank you all. Thank you all the participants for joining us today. Thank you, Professor Singh, once again. I also want to extend my thanks to Sonal and Meghna for all the technical support, Vikas for helping us out at every point, and Surinder ji, he is always there with us and for us. So thank you, all of you. Thank you so much. I hope you all benefited from this session. Thank you. Yeah, we are keeping we are keeping this session for open for 5 minutes more, 5-10 minutes more. If you haven't been able to fill up the attendance form, please do it now. Right? The attendance form link.
Professor Singh, if you want to leave, you may. This is just for a tech thing. Yeah.
Okay, bye.
Bye, bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye. Yeah, Sonal, please post the link again. If any of you could not fill the attendance form, they can do it now. We are open for 10 more minutes.
Right.
Thank you all for joining us. Yeah.
Thanks, Shilpa. I'll also take your leave. Participants, thank you so much. Hope you had a very, very good time and listening in to this fantastically informative, speaker. And Sonal, Meghna, Vikas, Surinderji.
Thank you, ma'am.
Heartfelt thanks. Shilpa, fabulous. Very, very well done. Very well conducted. And yes, let us get it in order. Those participants who are here, a request to you, do not get, you know, nervous. Not reaching you, it will take a little bit of time. Please be patient for it. Okay? Don't bombard us with emails. We will send you your certificate. Don't worry. Give us about 4-5 days for it. Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Thank you. So then we'll keep the meeting on for 10 minutes more. Yeah, Meghna.
Ma'am, chat ka backup bhi lena rahega.
Haan, chat ka backup bhi lena hai aur recording ka bhi aa jayega. I think recording ka Surinder ji ko bol denge. I think the recording have to be
thank you for your
Sorry. Yeah. I think one person
Mallikarjun sir. Yes, sir, please. PPT? Okay, regarding... Yeah, some people are asking about PPT. Yeah, regarding PPTs, we'll approach the resource person. So if the resource person is coming, we are going to share. Yeah, certificates will be coming to you all within 7 days. Give us 7 days time before that your certificates mail will come to you.
Also, there is a link that has been provided where the certificates will be uploaded. They can check there also, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, the link, when you have submitted your attendance, in that mail itself, the certificate from the folder link has come from where they can download the certificates.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, madam, for your suggestion.
Hello.
Regarding the chats and recording, I think Sonal Meghna, Surinder ji, se ek baar baat kar lijiye. They will tell you the procedure. Yeah.
Okay. When will be the next meeting, ma'am?
We are definitely going to organize more webinars very shortly. So we will keep updating you.
Okay, Shilpa ma'am. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Bye, ma'am.
Sonal, please check how many responses we have got in the Excel file. Because this time we said one person can fill it only
182.
Once.
182. One person buns ka humne hata diya tha last minute limit.
Okay. Haan, there must be some repeated entries also.
Those who have already filled their attendance form, they can leave the group. Yeah, right now.
Yeah. If you have filled the attendance form already, please leave the group. We are just waiting. If there's anybody still left who hasn't filled the attendance form, they can leave. Others may leave now. So Sonal, we'll keep it open for 5 minutes and then you can wind up. Okay?
Ji. Surinder sir ka call nahi lag raha hai, ma'am. Meghna, can you call him?
I think there is still somebody saying they are not able to fill the attendance form.
Ma'am, if anyone has not been able to fill the attendance form or copy from the chat, please ye link ko aap apne browser mein jaake type kijiye, wahan par aapka link khul jayega. Those who are not able to copy or click on the link, please is link ko as it is type kijiye browser mein, aapko attendance form aa jayega, usko fill kar dijiye.
Hello madam.
Ji.
Yes sir.
Ji sir.
Madam, did you send the attendance form? No.
Yes, sir. We have shared the link for attendance form. Did you fill this?
No, madam. Not yet. I received.
Sir, I am pasting it again in the chat. You can do it.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir. The meeting link, the attendance form link is there in the chat box. Please click on it.
I have filled. Can you please confirm somehow that I have it is filled?
Yeah, if you have filled it, then a confirmation mail will come to you. Please check your mailbox.
All right, ma'am. Thank you.
आपको सर मेल आ जाएगी वापस. एक छोटा लिंक भी दिया सर. We have given the short link. https /forms.gle प्लीज इसको चेक कीजिए आप. If you are not able to copy it or if you are not able to click on the link, then please इस link को as it is type कर दीजिए अपने browser में, वहां पर आपको form मिल जाएगा. Ma'am, someone is asking, send the mail of the certificate and not a copy. We are not sending the copy of the certificate. Rather, we'll be uploading the certificates on a particular link. Jo aap attendance form, whatever attendance form link you are filling it up, you will get a revert mail for the same in your Gmail or whatever mail ID you have given. Wahan par us response mein, you will be getting the link for downloading the certificate. And the certificates will be available from 10th onwards. Please give us time for 2-3 days. We'll be uploading all the certificates over there. You can directly download the certificate from that link.
Sonal, can you confirm me whether my attendance has been recorded or not?
Ma'am, did you get the mail back that you have filled your response? No.
But when I am opening the form, wo keh rahe hain ki this form can be filled only once and you have already done. But I have not filled it up. So that's why I'm asking.
Ma'am, you might be clicking on the registration form. I'm sending you the link for the form. Please, aap apna message check kijiye. I'm sending you the link. You please fill that link, not the any other link. Maine aapko abhi link bheja hai. Aap check kijiye.
Hello, ma'am. Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, I didn't even upload any information on my. Regarding my attendance, but it shows thank you for attending the webinar. E-certificates will be uploaded soon.
Yeah. No, that means you have filled the attendance form.
No, ma'am. I can't click that link.
Ma'am, I think wo e-certificates ka link hai, which I've just shared, wo open ho gaya hoga.
Okay.
Oh. You have sent it on WhatsApp.
Hello, ma'am. Yes.
No, who said just now? Yeah, please fill this. This is the attendance form.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Hanji, ji sir.
I have checked email. There is a confirmation for attendance. Thank
you. Okay, sir. You can leave the group now.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you. All those who have filled the attendance form, can please leave. We are just waiting for those who have still not been able to fill the form. Yeah, so if we can help you out in some way.
Madam?
Abhilasha, ma'am, I have just shared the link again. Agar aap usko copy nahi kar pa rahe hain, please type as it is in the browser and you will get the form over there.
Okay, ma'am, okay.
Sonal, ma'am, hello?
Yes, sir. Ma'am,
could you send the attendance form to my mail?
To your?
Mail. Email.
Sir, this link?
Yes, madam.
Sir, I'm sorry. Right now, we will not be able
I cannot work on that link.
Sir, can you please type it as it is in the browser in Google?
Okay,
this link as it is. Ji.
Okay.
Sir, you can actually copy paste. You can move your cursor.
Sorry, madam.
Able to copy it. Some people are not able to copy it because of their
I cannot copy that link.
Just paste it. Just type it as it is. You will get the link. You will get the link.
I think there were many people who said that they had a problem. I don't know why.
Because I don't know, ma'am. Many people can do that.
Yeah. Just few would have. And just in case if you are not able to fill up the attendance form, please do write your name and institution in the chat box. Right? So at least we have your name at least at one place. The link from where certificates will be downloaded, that is already there in your email box. You know, so when you fill up the attendance form, you get a confirmation mail. Usi confirmation mail mein hi wo folder mentioned hai jahan se aap e-certificates download kar sakte hain.
मैम सुरेंद्र जी का कॉल नहीं लग रहा.
विकास ट्राई कॉलिंग विकास.
ओके
I think there is one option there. Wait.
Can we take, madam?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you have filled your attendance forms, you can please take leave. That's okay. We are still waiting. If some people have problems.
Yeah.
Hello.
Vibha ma'am, aapka fill ho gaya attendance?
Haan ji, ma'am.
Okay, great.
Thank you. Achha, aapki कि मेरा सारा काम हो गया. कैन आई गो?
यस मैम.
यू मैडम.
नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन आई थिंक आई विल बी एबल टू डू दैट बिकॉज़ आई एम लॉग्ड इन दैट कैपेसिटी.
यस दिस इज द रीजन आई कैन नॉट सी एनी ऑप्शन. प्लीज इफ एनीवन हैज नॉट बीन एबल टू फिल द फॉर्म प्लीज लेट अस नो राइट नाउ. अदर्स दोज हु हैव फिल्ड अप द फॉर्म दे कैन टेक अ लीव. दे कैन लीव. यस सर यू कैन लीव मीटिंग.
Yes, Mallikarjun sir. Yes, sir. The session is over. We are just waiting so that if somebody needs our Vidhi Chaudhary, yeah, please unmute yourself. Vidhi.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, madam. My name is George Jason. How do I reach to your mail attendance form, madam? Please.
Attendance form, sir. Please go to chat box.
Sir, अभी post किया हमने again. Please last chat देखिए.
Okay.
And if you are not able to copy it, then type it as it is.
I should type it. You want it right away or it takes?
You can click it. You can click it right there.
Okay, good madam. I'll be.
Yeah. Just click it. Form right. Will come.
All right. Thank you, madam. Thank you. You want it right away, madam? Now only before
yes,
leaving?
Sir. Yes, sir. This is attendance form. This has to be filled.
One minute.
Yeah, we are waiting, sir.
those who have filled up the attendance form link can leave the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
I have got 192 responses, ma'am.
Yeah. I hope you have filled up the attendance form. आपके पास confirmation mail आ जाएगी. You can check your mailbox. उसी confirmation mail में ही folder का link mentioned है, जहाँ आप ये certificate download कर सकते हैं. Yeah. So is anybody left who hasn't been able to fill up the attendance form? Please let us know. Otherwise, we'll end the meeting now. All right. I hope everyone has filled it. All right. Thank you all. I'm ending the meeting. Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah, Vidhi, you said, have you been able to? Okay. Yeah, I think people have been able to. Abhilasha, please unmute yourself. Kahan hai aap?
Hello.
Yeah, Abhilasha, yeah.
Ma'am, I can't fill that link, fill that attendance form, ma'am.
Please go to the chat box. Please open the chat box.
Hi, yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, the last message, that is the link. Please click on that. Usme click kar dijiye.
Yeah, ma'am, I'm just clicking, but it can't open. I can't open that link.
Ma'am, can you copy this?
No, ma'am, I can't copy that link.
If you can't copy this, then please इस link को आप एक pen paper से लिख लीजिए. Please write down on a paper this link and go to your Google browser, type it as it is over there, and you'll get the form.
Ma'am, I'm opening that link. Yeah. But it shows email address and name, designation, department.
Yes, yes, yes. You have to fill this and in the end, click on the submit button.
I have did that, ma'am, already.
You have did
but
that?
But I didn't receive any email.
Ma'am, did you do it today or have you done it for the registration?
Abhilasha Prabhu 93 is the email ID.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you have already done, ma'am. You can leave the group.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Anyone who is left, please let us know. And those who have already filled the attendance form, please leave the meeting so that we can get the idea who all are left.
I think people have done it now, Sunil. Yeah, I think we can end the meeting. Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you all the participants.
Vidhi has written, ma'am.
आप रिकॉर्डिंग स्टॉप करके वो अपने आप कन्वर्ट करेगा एंड में आपको ऑप्शन देगा तो यू कैन कन्वर्ट. हाँ जी
विधि.